The views and opinions expressed in this broadcast do not necessarily reflect or represent the views and opinions of WBGR Network. Good morning, good morning. Happy Friday. I'm so glad that you could tune in today for the Wanda's Warrior Show. Today is February the 14th, so happy Valentine's Day to everyone that's watching. Happy Love Day. If you are single, love on yourself. If you have a significant other, love on that other person as well as yourself. So I'm going to have an amazing show. I'm glad to be back today. Last week I had knee surgery, so I am in a brace right now. I had to have someone to drive me here. So I want to thank all of you all who have reached out with your prayers, who have sent food, who come by, who have brought me food, the fruit baskets, the flowers, the texts, the calls. I really appreciate each and every one of you that have reached out. It's just blessed my soul. Just never know when you will need people. So I really thank you all for that. Today, I need you all to call in because it's going to be an amazing show. So the number to dial in is 301-429-9247. The number is 301-429-9247. So today is Valentine's Day, February the 14th. So what is Valentine's Day? It is celebrated annually on February the 14th. Valentine's Day is recognized as a significant cultural, religious, and commercial celebration of romance and romantic love in many regions around the world. It is known as a Christian and ancient Roman tradition. In the United States, approximately 190 million Valentine's Day cards are sent each year. Valentine's Day is a major source of economic activity. So for the month of February, every Friday I will be having a couple on my show to talk about love, their journey to love, and these couples are married. So today I want to introduce you to Tanya and Toya Blake. They have been married for over 40 years. Yes, when you look at them, you know, they look in their 20s. Yeah, they look young. But yes, they have been married
forever.
And I just love this couple dearly. They are just down to earth. And within the last, I would say, 5 or 6 years or so, I've really got to, you know, be around them more and just see how they love on each other. And I've been keeping notes for when God sends my king to have someone like Toya, you'll see. So I want to introduce everyone to Tanya and Toya Blake. Show them some love, show some hearts, share this video, start a watch party. So everyone, Tanya and Toya Blake, I'm so glad to have you both on my show.
Glad to be
and
here.
Then to be on Valentine's Day. So that can speak volumes of your love for each other. So we want to start with the basics. How did you meet? And either one can go first.
You go ahead first.
Well, I was in Toya's neighborhood at my girlfriend's house. We were washing the car, and Toya was walking through his neighborhood to let the neighbors know that his brother had passed. And of course, I didn't know him at all. So he comes up and he says hi. He stops and talks to my girlfriend, and he's mm-hmm. telling her, I can't hear what he's telling her. And then he comes around to the side of the car where I am and says hi, tells me his name. So I thought he was pretty bold. So I, at that point, I didn't give him my real name.
Yes.
I just told him my name was Carolyn. And thinking, okay. You know.
Started off with a lie.
Yes.
But no, can I say something? Yes. So when I heard the story of yes. Carolyn, I put you in my cell phone. I put Tanya in parentheses, but then I put dash Carolyn. So when she would come, oh, there's Carolyn. Yes.
And Toya sometimes will call me Carolyn as the joke. And then in that same space of time, my girlfriend calls my name. She's like, Tanya. And he thought
like, oh,
that they were calling him. They didn't hear me tell him that my name was Carolyn. And he says, what do they call you? And I said, oh, Tanya. And then, you know, of course, I told him my name. So
yeah. So I met her like that, and I asked her name. She told me it was Carla. But anyway, Sandra, her friend, said she heard her. She's a little mm-hmm. older. She said, Tanya, pass me that rag out the bucket. You know, she was, you know, she knew she was telling a fib, you know. So I said, okay. And she had this little necklace charm on her neck, a little gold necklace, mm-hmm. and it had a charm that says, try me.
Oh, wow.
You know, so like that, you know, I said, so I'm thinking. I said, if you were my girl, you wouldn't be wearing that.
Oh, wow. And why is that?
Because I wouldn't want nobody to be trying you.
Okay.
No, so
men, y'all taking notes?
So I was straightforward with her, and it went from there. And she had to go to Baltimore. They went to Baltimore that mm-hmm. day. I didn't leave the neighborhood. I stayed when the little Volkswagen pulled back up. I was still in.
Yeah, you know, Volkswagen.
It pulled up. And so from that day, I held her hand and started talking to her.
Mm-hmm.
So we talked the whole night, and I told her that I really liked her. So mm-hmm. we started right there.
And how old were you at that time?
Fresh out of high school and on my way to college.
So how did you know that you wanted to get to know Tanya / Carolyn further?
Well, first of all, she was in the alley washing a car mm-hmm. from my neighborhood. I left, my brother had passed, and I was going up the street to my friend's house to tell him that my mm-hmm. brother had just passed, but I saw this lady in these bright clothes, you know, and it caught my eye. So I stopped. I was running,
mm-hmm.
and I stopped and said, let me wait for a minute. I went back to talk to her, you know, because she was a stranger in my neighborhood to me.
Okay.
So, and I spent that whole day concentrating on her. I never made it to my friend's house.
Wow.
So that was real. I saw what I liked. And that's history, you know.
Wow. So that first conversation you had on the phone, what did you all talk about? Was just trying to get to know each other and
the phone. Okay. Mm-hmm. Furthermore, as far as the phone, it wasn't a whole lot of phone conversation.
Oh.
When I would get on the phone to talk to her, my mother would pick up the phone on the other side and say, Toya, get off my phone.
We could
talk on the phone for a long time. So I would go visit. It was
yeah.
more than 5 minutes.
Okay, yeah.
It was more than 5 minutes. You got to go visit. So
okay.
we talked.
We did a lot of visiting
mm-hmm. face-to-face,
yeah.
walking, talking.
Meeting okay. at the park. I would meet him in the park.
Okay.
Yeah. I was 17 when I met Toya.
Okay.
I was 18.
Yeah.
And how long did you all date before you got married?
From 74 to 2 years.
Okay.
Because I was 20 when we got married.
Okay.
So
yeah.
Toya asked my parents earlier
okay.
if he could marry me when I, you know, turned 18. And my mom and dad were like, no, let her grow up. Oh. You know, she's too immature. Come back. My dad was like,
she was spoiled.
Come back.
You were spoiled.
So, yeah, yeah. And so Toya went back. When he went back, my dad was like, we thought you would have been back, wow. You know, to ask us. Mm-hmm. So.
So yeah. How did you feel that he went to your parents? Because a lot of times people today don't do that.
No.
They don't do that.
No.
They, you know, they don't feel that they need that authority, but that approval.
Yes.
Especially from a female's father. Mm-hmm. So how did you feel that he went to your parents?
Well, I didn't mind that because, you know, I knew. But when my dad said yes, I cried because Toya told me that my dad told him, look, you came and asked us for her. He said, if you change your mind and you ever don't want her, bring her back.
Wow.
And when Toya told me that, I cried because I knew they loved me, but you don't know until you hear something like that. So I cried over that because that made me feel emotional. My dad was like, I mean it. Mm-hmm. If you ever change your mind, you know, bring her back where you where you found her. And so
don't abuse
special
her.
Special about that.
And then your brother told me that too.
Did he?
He said, whatever you do, don't abuse my sister.
Yeah.
You know, so that's good, but I wasn't going to abuse
anyone.
They
looked out for you.
Right. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I loved her, you know, and I still do.
Still do after all these years.
Yes, you know, it was us, and then it was everybody else.
Yeah.
But yet we still have family, you know, because that's the way it is. Yeah.
And then today, you have people of different faiths. Right. Coming together, you know, people will say the scripture, do not be unequally yoked.
Yes.
So did you come from different denominations, different faiths? And if so, how did you decide, how did that conversation go to say, okay, we're going to go with this particular faith?
Well, let me talk on that. When I met Tanya, I was a backslidden young man, you know.
Okay.
But I ran track, played football. I wasn't in church. I was in church, and then when I got in high school, I kind of deviated, and I spent a lot of time in sports. So when I met her, and I told her, I said, well, I'm going to go to church. And the girls that go to my church, they wear their dresses down here.
To the ankles.
You know.
Can't see
and,
nothing.
You know, Tanya wore dresses. Her dress was like right up here.
No, Tanya, you didn't wear the dresses.
He said
dresses was up here.
Like, you know, that's a little exaggerated.
Anything,
out and all that, but I liked all that. Okay.
Yes.
But, you know, she was a little 5'6". She was about 98 pounds.
Oh, Lord.
I was 145 at the max.
Wow.
Full of muscles, and you know, I couldn't keep 150 pounds, you know. So you know, I knew the life that I wanted to live. Mm-hmm. You know, I knew that it was gonna be in church. She went to church, but you know, she just went to church and then they just do what they want to do, you know.
Mm-hmm. At my church, the church that I attended at that time, we did cabarets and parties, and when service was over, the people stood out on the church and smoked cigarettes. This is what I'm thinking his church is like. And when he said they don't dress like this at his church, I was like, okay, then go get the girls at your church, because this is how I'm dressing. You know, I was, you know, sassy at that time. Like, this is my look.
Mm-hmm.
And then he invited me to his church, and he kept saying to me, when I go back to church. But I didn't get it. I'm thinking, just go to church.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't realize for him it was a lifestyle.
Okay.
And a more serious commitment than what I was used to for church. You just go to church.
Mm-hmm.
Come home. It didn't change your life.
Mm-hmm.
And then he invited me to his church, and I went. And the first day I went, I never left.
Wow.
I went that day and...
Something got a hold of me.
I thought, Holy Ghost. What I see in this church is what I want in my life. The pastor at that time, Bishop Ralphie Green.
Happy heavenly birthday.
Happy heavenly birthday, Ralph Bishop Green. Green.
Yes.
Changed my life. His method.
Wow. Yes.
The teaching. Words.
Gospel.
His sincerity.
Mm-hmm.
His care for souls.
Mm-hmm.
The way he taught on that day, I wanted that in my life.
And it was plain. His teaching was plain. Absolutely. Straight, no chaser.
My gosh.
You know.
My God. Yes.
Convert anyone.
Yes.
Yes.
Know,
listening
yes.
to that.
Yes.
True.
Yeah.
And so. That's it. And that's the life I was going to live. Because, mm-hmm. see, I come from, you look at me now, you just see a nice, clean guy.
Yeah.
I was an athlete, but I was dealing with drugs, marijuana.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The whole night.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And you don't see that because mm-hmm. I was delivered from all that.
Exactly.
So I got control mm-hmm. of all that through the power of God.
Yeah.
But I love Tanya.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I don't need nobody to tell me who I can love or,
yeah.
you know, because mm-hmm. there's women in the church.
Mm-hmm.
They're looking for a good man.
Yes.
I was a boy, but I'm mm-hmm. a man, you know,
yeah.
and I have vision, you know, and so, mm-hmm. and so this was it for me, mm-hmm. you know. And yeah. it still is.
There's a a prophetess that I follow, and she got married a couple years ago, and she did a short video clip that I still saved in my phone, and she said like she trusted what her parents felt about who she was going to marry, and
yes.
like her pastor, and just like a very small intimate group, and so the name of the clip is called "Whose No Can You Trust."
Mm-hmm.
It's just it's powerful. It's less than 2 minutes.
Yes.
So if your father or if Toya, your parent, told you no, you can't marry Tanya because at first she wasn't from your faith. And,
right.
you know, we were brought up, you know, you generally you had to marry someone mm-hmm. in that
yeah,
denomination,
yeah. Mm-hmm.
you know, that faith that we was in. Would you trust them, what they were saying, or would you just know what God was telling you?
I would know what God was telling me, but furthermore, that question, I asked my father.
Wow.
I said, "You think I should marry?" He said, "Why are you asking me?
you already
made up your mind. Don't ask me."
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, that's the way it was. You know,
yeah.
my father had a lot of kids. My grandfather, his father, Nathan Blake Sr., he had 5 girls and 5 boys.
Wow.
My father was the oldest.
Mm-hmm.
My bloodline was to do it like that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, to do it right. It's in my bloodline.
Okay.
I look at my grandfather, and when I finally went down North Carolina to visit my grandfather with my wife, he loved her right away.
Wow.
He loved Tanya.
That's special.
It's just my girl. And Tanya, here she is. She's like, granddaddy. You know, I got a granddaddy. Why? Because my grandmother died.
Mm-hmm.
He said, "Granddaddy, why don't you get married? Why don't you get married again?" Because in my granddaddy, he had a friend around the corner,
mm-hmm.
and he wasn't driving no more. He was like 90-something. He got a friend around the corner. He got a friend around the other corner.
Oh, whoa.
He had breakfast around here.
Dinner over there.
He had dinner over there. And they both knew one another.
Oh. Wow.
Okay. It was just companionship, friendship.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, but they're older. But Tanya said, "Well, granddaddy, why don't you marry one of these women?" My granddaddy said, no way.
Wow.
I only love one woman.
He did. Wow. He did.
I mean, he could have married one of those.
Mm-hmm.
But no, he only was married
wow.
one time. And that was maybe 20, 30 years ago.
He said one wife.
One wife.
Wow.
That's it. And he believed
one.
It.
Wow.
And that's the way we are taught.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
there's not a lot of people doing that now.
No,
you know,
no,
they trade
not.
You in for a new
in a year.
Year and a half, 6 months.
Very
you
good.
Know, but life is you know, you want something solid.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's what I want.
Yeah.
Because I've seen, I was younger, I saw men coming to the house,
yeah.
eating breakfast, leaving. Somebody else come.
Mm-hmm.
A lady got 5-6 kids.
You didn't want that.
I don't want that type of life,
mm-hmm.
you know. And so you have to practice right to be right.
I like that. Practice right to be right.
Yeah.
And, you know, so if I fall in some other patterns,
mm-hmm.
you know, I don't know where we'd be today.
Yeah.
But because of teaching,
mm-hmm.
gospel, and Jesus Christ and examples,
yeah.
you know, like Mother Green, Shirley Green, they raised a lot of kids.
Yeah.
They did.
They weren't their kids.
Besides their three, they
had
hundreds
see,
of kids, thousands of kids.
So they get a pass from me.
Mm-hmm. They put a lot of energy.
You know.
Yes.
And so it's Valentine's Day. I remember we used to go to church, and on Valentine's Day, Tanya and I, we would get together with married couples. Mm-hmm. The single couples couldn't come to this event. It'd be like 50 of us.
Yeah.
And me and a couple of brothers, like Carl Eisler, a couple of brothers, we used to spend our money. We used to go to the wholesaler. We were smart. We used to go to the wholesaler. We would buy a bunch of roses, long-stem roses, and we would go to the little knick-knack places like the dollar store, mm-hmm. and we'd buy a whole lot of vases, single vases.
Okay.
Fill them with water. We were organized. We filled them with water and put the roses in them, you know, because it's all about love, you
know.
Yeah.
And then we would invite the couples out. We'd get all the brothers and the sisters together, and we would go to the different restaurants, and we would rent a whole area, put the roses on the table with the bottles and the whole mm-hmm. bit. When it was over with, all the ladies would be able to
that
take a roll.
So yeah. Special.
That's what we used to do.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. We were about that, and I'm just going through things in the past.
Yeah.
So it was about trying to do lovely things mm-hmm. for your life.
Yeah, because love is an action word.
It is.
Yeah.
You know, and you just can't say I love you that one time and then that's it. You have to be consistent.
Yes.
Yes.
You know, and like in today's society, one of the cliches that you will hear a lot of is each person gives 50-50.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I personally don't believe in that cliche because if you're giving a person 50, you're only giving them half.
Right.
I'm not giving you all. So what do you think about that?
I think you should give your all.
Well, I think 50-50 is unrealistic.
Yeah.
So there are days when I feel like I'm giving 110.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And there are days when I feel like there are times in life, and specifically mm-hmm. in marriage, where you feel like, I'm not getting anything. Like, what are you doing?
Yeah.
And that person.
You go through seasons.
Yes. Yeah. Can look back at you and say, what? You know, I've given all I have. What are you giving?
Mm-hmm.
Right.
So it's never, if you're looking for 50-50,
no.
You probably don't want to start.
That's only in bingo.
Exactly.
50 raffle.
Exactly.
That's only in bingo.
It's sometimes you both have to give
mm-hmm.
yeah.
everything that you have and then find some more.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
You know?
That's true. Now, how do you handle conflict in your marriage?
We've had that. Look
at this. Lots of conversations. You know, sometimes there's yelling, sometimes there's screaming, sometimes mm-hmm. there's no talking,
mm-hmm.
you know, sometimes there's pouting, you know, adult tantrums.
Yeah.
No, these things aren't from him. These are my things.
She's spoiled.
But, you know,
she's spoiled.
These are my things. So I'm saying, and then, you know, you get back to the conversation. Mm-hmm. So, okay, we got to talk about this because,
mm-hmm.
you know, Toya tells me that you can't do that again. You know, I don't want that to happen. And I don't want to do that.
Mm-hmm.
I want to be my best self. But there are times when I feel like I'm not being heard
mm-hmm.
or maybe my choice of words, or sometimes I don't have the words to express
what you're saying,
what I'm feeling,
yeah.
you know, what's bothering me. So, you know, those kinds of things.
Yeah, because men and women, we have a different... a different language.
Yes.
We talk differently.
Yes.
And we're going to talk more about that. We're going to break for a commercial break. And I asked Tanya, I said, what is you and Toya's favorite song? So on the commercial break, you will hear the song that she told me is their favorite song. So take a listen and we'll be back with more with Tanya and Toya Blake. Stay tuned.
My love, there's only you in my life, the only thing that's right.
My first love, you're every breath that I take, you're every step I make.
Tell me how long.
hearts that beat as one. Our lives have just begun. I'll hold you close in my arms. I can't resist your charms.
My love,
oh no, I'll be a fool for you, I'm sure.
You know.
Welcome back from the commercial break on the Wanda's Warriors show, and I hope that you enjoyed that song. It's Endless Love by Lionel Richie and Diana Ross. It's a timeless song. It would never get old, and you will hear that a lot of weddings. The lyrics to that song is just profound. So I want to ask you all a couple questions that I have written out, and you can choose whoever wants to answer it. First of all, prayer is important.
Absolutely.
Prayer is a form of communication, just like communication within itself is important.
Yes.
So do you all pray together, or do, I know some couples just pray if it's something that they need.
Yeah.
But do you pray for each other and together on a consistent basis?
Yes.
Yes.
Like
yes. Always.
Hold hands down at the foot of the bed when
yes.
you know, that type
yes.
of a yes. prayer.
In the bed. Anywhere, in the kitchen,
yeah.
in the family room.
Covers you.
And tells, we tell one another to pray for me, or
yeah,
pray
love
for
that.
So-and-so.
Yes.
Or if somebody's hurt or something, I might find out, I'll tell her,
okay.
to pray for this
mm-hmm.
person, and she does the
mm-hmm.
same for me.
Okay.
And
now,
we do a lot of stopping and praying.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
if you say, pray for so-and-so, I say, okay, let's pray for them right now.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we find out something.
Yeah.
Anyway, we
mm-hmm.
find it out.
Mm-hmm.
We stop and pray.
Yeah.
We pulled over to pray
yeah.
for people because
mm-hmm.
the urgency of prayer
yeah.
is a part of our lives.
It's now. You can't say, oh,
exactly.
we'll pray. Like, you know, in the older churches, you would have put people on the sick and shut-in list.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
mm-hmm.
but that's not until Sunday.
Exactly.
Right. But Bible
you know.
Says man ought to always pray.
Yeah.
Pray without ceasing.
Yeah.
So the way I am, somebody said, well, you should pray for somebody, but I'm always in a prayerful state of mind
mm-hmm.
as I go to and fro to work.
Okay.
I'm in different neighborhoods. You know,
mm-hmm.
I was like on Missouri Avenue working, and I heard a couple of gunshots. Ooh. Pow, 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 pow. And the traffic is stopped. The guy runs from over here, runs across the front of my vehicle.
Wow.
Run into the alley, jump in a vehicle, pulls off.
Wow.
And I'm right there. You know, I'm right there, and I'm seeing it.
You're seeing it unfold.
I'm seeing it unfold. And he could have stopped me and said, get out the vehicle.
True.
Take my vehicle and go. Mm-hmm. He might have not thought he had enough time to get to his vehicle. Mm-hmm. So this things happen.
Yeah.
Just like the news today was just horrible, but it's Valentine's Day, and people are getting killed.
And
shot.
It's Friday. Yeah. You know, it's the weekend. Yes. It's a holiday weekend, you know, so that brings on a bunch of other things. So before we go into the next question, I want to remind the viewers to you can call in and ask Tanya and Toya any questions, or if you want to give them comments. This year you'll be celebrating 44 years of marriage, and that is a phenomenal to be married that long to the same person. That is just speak volumes. So the number to call in is 301-429-9247. Now, I've seen this question has been a big debate, and I've been seeing it recently on Instagram from different pastors and so-called relationship coaches.
Okay.
And it's, do you believe that married couples can have a good friend of the opposite sex?
Okay, I have a lot of friends, but they're not my friends, though I'm talking to them all the time. She has a lot of friends, too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But they people. You have to be very mature, you know, to deal with that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But, you know, you can't have a fleshly relationship with a person.
Mm-hmm.
People that I talk to, they're not really my friends.
Mm-hmm.
They're just somebody that likes
associates.
Me.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we have a lot of friends, but we don't. So you say close friend. Both of us have a lot of friends of the opposite sex, but they are not our intimate friends.
Okay.
Meaning things. What we share with them is family, friends, community.
Mm-hmm.
But what goes on in our marriage is not shared with our friends of opposite sex.
Right.
Toya is that person.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like it or not, he has to be that person. I'm sure I tell him things he doesn't necessarily want to hear, but he has to hear them. And, you know, so anything that goes on with us is kept private, our marriage.
Mm-hmm.
Our friends, we do things together, and what has happened over the years is my friends have become his friends, and his friends have become my friends. So we share a lot of friends.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not insecure of his friendships because his friendships are set with boundaries, if that makes sense.
Mm-hmm. So for a couple that may be having an issue with that's watching, what kind of boundaries would you tell them to set?
It's us first, then it's everybody else.
Yeah.
You know, for real.
Mm-hmm.
You know, forsake all others and cleave to your wife.
Mm-hmm.
Bible. Straight.
Yeah.
That's bottom
it.
Line.
That's it.
If you deviate like this another male friend or a woman friend, if they deviate in any way whatsoever, I don't have no problem staking them. No, it's not a fleshly, lustful relationship.
Mm-hmm.
If I can't help you to get to the next level, you know, if I can't help you, maybe you need a psychiatrist or something.
Mm-hmm.
You do need Jesus.
Yes, but, definitely
know,
Jesus.
You know, so keeping it from going off, you know.
Yeah.
You know, like I have a lot of married friends.
Mm-hmm.
Like my pastor used to say, birds of a feather flock together. Okay, true. If I'm going to spend time with a bunch of guys that's running women, I really can't help them.
True. Mm-hmm.
You know, I can be their friend, but we're not friends, intimate friends.
Mm-hmm.
We're not, we might be going to some of the same places, functions.
Yeah.
I'm in entertainment, but I don't run women.
Yeah.
See, I can set an example by keeping myself. I have to look out. I have to save myself first.
Yeah.
Then I can save you.
That's true.
You know, so that's for a woman. That's for her or me.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
Yeah, and our friends are not disrespectful.
That's true.
So our friends respect us.
Mm-hmm.
They respect our marriage.
And that's important.
Yes.
And that's important. Mm-hmm. Now, for single people that you all may know, of how would you counsel them or give them advice on to look for a mate? Now, Toya, you have, or for me,
okay.
You know me, what would you tell me as a single female, saved female, to look for in a man? And would you want, if I'd be like, Tanya and Toya, going out on a date, and I know how you all are with me. If I brought that man to you, and you was like, what would he have done or said for you to be like, uh-uh, this ain't well, the
first,
one?
First of all.
Because I trust what y'all say.
You're my friend. Mm-hmm. And since you're my friend, I would actually ask the guy, what are your interests with mm-hmm. Wanda, mm-hmm. really?
Yeah.
And, you know, not all men.
Mm-hmm.
Some men might just say, well, we just going out to dinner. Or mm-hmm. We just, you know, we just talking. But, you know, he's going to have to tell me the truth. mm-hmm. See, some men, all they want is to have a physical relationship with a woman. Mm-hmm. And women know that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So she has to be wise and decide how she's going to handle the situation. Mm-hmm. You know, you have to grow up. You have to protect yourself.
True.
You know.
There are a lot of counterfeits out here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You know, I can't be with you
24/7.
Yeah. You know. And
But I look at small things.
Mm-hmm.
So we have you over. I'm looking at how he's responding to you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm looking to see if he has any interest. If the entire visit, let's say we get together to eat, and the entire visit, he's totally distracted and on his phone. At that point, in my mind, I'm going to tell Wanda, this guy's not for you. He's not into you. He's distracted.
Mm-hmm.
We have conversation. Our conversations are going to be positive. Let's see how you're thinking.
Yeah.
Let's, you know, we can talk about the food, but I want to get in, at our age, I want to get into some serious conversation.
Life conversations. Yes.
And if he's not interested or his remarks or answers are silly, you know, and I don't see maturity, and I don't see the things that I know are good for you.
Mm-hmm.
So if we're just having a conversation and he says, yeah, well, you know, I do church sometimes. Well, right away, I know this isn't going to work for you.
Yeah.
So, you got to have a balance.
You see what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So I'm looking at things. Toya and I look at two total different things.
Okay.
And, you know, I'm going to tell you what I have observed, you know?
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
I like that.
I ain't about a whole lot of talking.
He said he ain't about a whole bunch of talking.
He's not.
Okay, well, here's a fun question.
Okay.
Who is more organized?
Toya.
For real?
He is.
Toya.
My stuff is, I'm telling you, I get there, but the way I get there is crazy.
Instead of A, B, C, you doing A, M,
anything,
Z.
Anything. And I know it. My mind doesn't work the way most people's. Toya is very methodical.
Mm-hmm.
He's very, you know, he's organized. He has his stuff together.
Mm-hmm.
And me, I get there if you give me the time and I reach it.
We don't have no more time.
But what it
and
looks
he said,
like
we don't have
awake,
no more time.
You know what I mean? And I don't realize what it looks like until I come back.
Mm-hmm.
I've completed the thing and then I look around me and I'm like,
yeah.
Well, I went through all of that
to get here.
Yes.
Who cooks the most?
Me.
Yeah.
Me.
Now, if you all are going somewhere and that you get lost, who is more than likely to ask for directions?
Well,
who is more than likely to ask for directions?
Me. I think I ask for directions before I go through a whole lot of changes. But this is it. I don't get lost. Before I go,
you
I map it
out.
Yeah. It's mapped out. I know where I'm going. The little lady on the GPS be talking.
Look,
the little lady on the GPS be trying to turn right here. I already have it in my brain. I done looked at the map. I know which way to go, what street to go down. And she said, no, do the GPS. But look. I'm there because it's in
your mind.
Yeah. So I said, well, I'm going to try it your way, honey. Okay. I'm going to try it your way. Just do the GPS.
I'm going to try it your way, honey.
So we go ahead, put the GPS on. The little lady, the place is right here.
Mm-hmm.
The little lady's going to take you over here. Back
there.
Over there.
Yes.
Back, wasting my time. I don't have no time to waste. I'm getting old. I'm I want to get there so I can have some more time to myself. You know? Okay, so here we go. I done looked at the map. So I get here. I'm going to make a left turn. I'm right there. Mm-hmm. The GPS lady's going to take you to the mall, take you past some stores, back through some woods.
No, and you're like, wait a minute. No, I could have saved 15 minutes. Yeah.
Right.
You know?
That
see,
stuff
we're very different.
Yeah, see, that stuff was made for people that don't follow direction.
That's what GPS was.
But it is. It is. But I don't care. So Toya cares that it's from A to B.
Mm-hmm.
Part of his organization. I don't care. So if we take a wrong turn or we are on the wrong street,
we're not
or
lost.
Whatever, I always say, okay, we're not lost. Let's mm-hmm. see what's over here.
Yeah.
Well, he doesn't want to do that at all.
Not
he
today.
He doesn't
not
want
today.
To discover anything.
Especially not today.
And he's like, not today. So, you know, hey, hurry up. I want to get over here. I'm like, okay, but hold on. Because we just failed. Mm-hmm. You know, just.
But, oh, I didn't know that
yes,
was on this street.
Yes, you and know? That drives mm-hmm. him crazy. That drives him crazy.
When I'm really trying to go somewhere.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And then all those little rides when you first married or you're young, mm-hmm. you just, wherever, you, it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
But when you been married for a while, my time is more valuable than
yeah.
money.
Yeah.
You know, my time. I want mm-hmm. my time. And I'm trying to tell that.
We're opposite in that
respect.
That is so funny. I was reading an article, and this is always a debate regarding divorce. And one video I saw on Facebook, and it said, when people get together and say the term divorce is not an option, that term is a cliche because actually
yes.
divorce is an option, because if it wasn't, then it divorce rate wouldn't be at 50%.
Yeah.
So when you all got together, did you all have a conversation to say, look, I know the vows say for better, for worse, through sickness and health. Mm. You mad, you just go
mad.
On the couch, but you're not leaving this house.
Just mad.
You know, you're just mad. But we are not getting divorced, because some families, it can be generational. You know,
yeah.
we know about curses, generational
yeah.
curses. The mother got divorced, the grandmother got divorced, the great-grandmother got divorced,
yeah.
and it just flows. It keeps going. So did you all have a conversation to say, look, babe, hey, against all odds, we're not going anywhere.
It's us.
Us.
Yeah. And them.
Us and them.
Yeah.
And that was decided early on.
Early, yeah. It was, yeah. What I wanted.
In it for life.
In it for life.
Yeah.
In it for life. And I love it.
Yeah.
Because you're coming up on 44 years.
Don't seem like it, but
I
it
know.
Is.
You don't think that one.
We. I look back at pictures and I say, wow, that was 25 years ago.
Wow.
That was 15 years ago.
Wow.
Yeah. It's a blessing.
It is a blessing.
It's encouraging.
Yeah, it is.
Because you get tired of everything.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But you rejuvenate.
Mm-hmm.
It's coming back around.
Yeah.
You know,
mm-hmm.
I thank God for health and strength.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to appreciate that.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah. Now I want to talk about support, because Toya, I'm throwing this plug, is in a band,
okay.
and it's called Still For Real.
Yes.
If you all have not heard Still For Real, you are really missing out
yes.
on some awesome singers,
yes.
you know, the... Toya, Johnny Steele, Johnny Steele's wife, and
Shekinah Steele, his
daughter. Awesome. Any type of events, gospel events, R&B, whatever.
Yes.
Toya, you have the phone number to give to them?
Look
Toya up on
Facebook.
Stillforreal.com.
Yeah.
So support, to me, that's important in a marriage. Well, in a relationship, you know,
yeah.
because it's like if Toya is out doing something for Still For Real, and I know that you support him, you know, whenever you
yes.
can. And then you have couples that may say, like, or they're in ministry.
Yeah.
And they're like, well, my wife doesn't support me, or my husband doesn't support me, if you're an author or a singer
yeah.
or whatever.
Balance.
How important is support to each of you? And if you could each say something on that.
It's very important
mm-hmm.
because... I don't want to be out by myself.
Yeah.
yeah.
I don't want her to be out by herself.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Whether I'm doing the R&B or whether she's with her girlfriends doing
mm-hmm.
some stuff, I still miss her.
Yes.
I need support.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Because when I'm out, you get support from strangers,
mm-hmm.
yeah.
which is just fine. It's, you
yeah.
know,
mm-hmm.
you want to entertain. But... you need your own support.
That spouse to be like,
yes, yes.
that's a good note, baby.
Yeah.
Sing that song,
yeah.
you know, because
yeah,
you
yeah,
sing.
Yeah,
yeah,
you know, you need You need that support. Whatever it is in any relationship, you have to support one another. You have to communicate. Mm-hmm. It's not about somebody else's plan for you to do things for them. It's about your plan. Like I say, I say it again, it's us.
Us.
Yeah. And then it's them.
And then it's them.
Yeah.
And what are your thoughts, Tanya?
Well, for years, for 30 years, I was real active, you know, at church and working on different committees. Mm-hmm. And Toya at church singing. But the things that I had to do at church involved a lot of planning and banquets and events and dinners and affairs. And Toya supported me 100%. Mm-hmm. He was always there. And I would set up what I was going to do based on his support and help of me. Mm-hmm. So he would help me. He would he would have to go with me to the banquets and go early, and some of the footwork and legwork, go with me on this appointment to meet with these people.
Yeah.
Bring these things from the car. Sometimes he would have to drive, and I would have to drive separate because I would have a car full of stuff that he would bring. So he always supported me. So I've had that for years in my marriage prior to him being in the band. Mm-hmm. And then once it, you know, my responsibilities changed, and then his change to the band, mine was supporting him in the band. So I don't always physically go with him, but I support him in ways even before he goes. Yeah. So I make sure I pick up his clothes from the cleaners. I make sure his clothes are in the cleaners, put his shirts, you know, bae, I, you know, wash a couple of shirts for you. You know, they're ready. I make sure if they're going to a hotel, like he has change. I get up, make sure there's gas in his car. Bae, I didn't notice the drums were in your car. Did you, you know, little things that I can do to make sure. If I'm working that day or I'm doing something else, I make sure I leave food that he can eat before going to his event, so he's not showing up at his event hungry. So the things you can do to support that's not always physical support.
Yeah.
And then when I get back, and he's not back, I'll wait up for him. Now, I might be asleep in the chair or, you know, sleep on the sofa, but he knows
you're
there. And I'm waiting for him. And then when he gets in, we go through the whole set. I'm saying, okay, so what did you sing? So what did you da-da-da? When I go, I support him by taking videos of the group.
Okay.
When I can, videos and pictures, and I give those to him and to the group. And so my support is not always the same type of support, but I make sure that I fully support.
Your presence is always great for me.
Yes. I love that. Yes. I love it. I'm just, this has been great dialogue, and you know, a lot of people have commented in there saying they love me some them. Great couple indeed. So you all are well loved, you know, by a lot of the people, you know, that are watching, not just me.
Thank the Lord.
So I just want to thank you for coming on the show, you know, as we wrap up, and just wishing you all more years of blissful marriage.
Thank you.
You know, 44, that's a significant length of years, you know, to be together. So I want to thank you all for being the first on my show on my first day back. And, you know, I just love you all both. And so, at the end of each show, I do a food for thought.
Okay.
And so I was thinking of what to do.
Yes.
For the food for thought. And there is this song, and it's a song that I've always wanted to play at my wedding.
Okay.
And the lyrics remind me of something that Toya would say to you.
Okay.
Tanya.
Okay.
So the song is called The Blessing. Okay. Have you all heard it? It's by Will Downing. Mm-hmm. Have you ever heard of that song?
No, I haven't heard
of that song.
I can't think of it.
He did gospel.
For real?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I didn't realize Will Downing, and I like Will Downing.
It's called The Blessing.
Okay.
So I want to read some of the lyrics to, the Instagram just cut off.
Okay.
Some of the lyrics to the song, and that's how I'm going to end the food for thought.
Okay.
So it says, I searched all day and into the night to find a love I could call mine. Time has sustained a joy in my heart, knowing one day I'd feel where you are. Together forever is more than a passing thought, embracing the comfort of sharing a love that never gets lost. Enter this life where we are two, sharing our joy in the prime of our youth. Your love is my dream that somehow came true. God knew my heart. He blessed me with you.
Wow.
So subtle the wish when I came to see the angel in you looking down upon me. I smiled at you, you smiled back with your eyes. Loved how it felt to be frozen in time. You are the woman who defines the me that I am. You're how it feels to be touched and caressed by God's hands. Enter this life where two become one, blessed in our love that's never undone. Your love is my dream that somehow came true. God knew my heart when he blessed me with you.
That is true. Beautiful.
Oh, yes. That's nice.
So that's my food for thought.
That is
for
beautiful.
You. And you have
thank
to pull
you,
it up
Wanda.
On YouTube or whatever. It's called The Blessing by Will Downing.
I will.
And just the music to the
wow.
song, the lyrics. And I was like,
it's awesome.
It's a love amazing. Song to the woman, but it's also displaying his love for God, that
yes.
he told God what he wanted,
yes.
and God honored
yes.
his prayer.
Thank the Lord.
And that's important. So thank you all for tuning in today for the Valentine's Day. I hope of Wanda's Warriors. Thank you again for your prayers.
Yes.
I'm still in this brace,
yes.
and it's killing me sitting here. But thank you all so much. And tune in next week. My guest next week will be Apostle Wayne Green
Yay.
And Pastor Michelle
Yay.
Green. So tune in next week at 11 a.m. from
yes.
12 p.m. on the WBGR Gospel Network.
Yes.
And remember that my motto is to live out loud. So enjoy your
yes.
Valentine's Day. I love you all.
Yes.
Be safe. It's an extended weekend. See you back next week. Bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye.